Hello and welcome to a ZAP chat video about the ZAP break functionality. Now the break functionality has been in ZAP since day one. So why record a video about it now? Well, it's thanks to this tweet from Cyberglitch James, who asked for a video on the break functionality, was looking for one, and my immediate reaction was, well, of course I must have recorded a video about break until I tried to find it and then realized I probably haven't. And we want to know what videos to record as part of this series, so this seemed like an ideal opportunity to record something that we know people want. So let's switch to ZAP, and I'm going to use Budget because it's nice and simple application, so we can see exactly what's going on. And the break functionality is very much a manual technique, and so that's why I'm going to use the ZAP UI. We do have an API for it, but that's really for if you're controlling ZAP with another application. So look at Budget, and what we'll see is if you go to the product, you can add a product to your basket. Trouble is the quantity field we can't type in, and the JavaScript controls don't allow us to put anything less than 1 or more than 12 in the basket. Now, as security people, we want to test the exception cases. We want to try things out. And this is annoying, the fact that we can't control these values from the UI. But there are lots of other values we won't be able to control from the UI, like hidden fields. So it's not an unusual case. And what we want to do is we want to change things on the fly. And because ZAP is sitting in between the browser and the target application, that's exactly what we can do. So if we go back to ZAP and look at the main toolbar, you'll see a button here which says set break on all requests and responses, although you can't see all of that because my picture's in the way, never mind. But it's this green button, and if I press it, then it turns red and it will change to saying unset the breakpoint. So go back to the browser, and then I will add to the basket, and immediately by default control switches to ZAP. And you'll see we're using now is this break tab here, and what we have is we have the post request from the browser, or it's whatever request is next in this case, but in this case it's the post, and we see the data as well, post data. Now we can change absolutely anything here. We can change any of these headers, we can do whatever we like, but the most interesting thing usually, sometimes it's header values, but it's often the post data. And we can see a product ID, we can see a price and a quantity. Well, let's change the price to something big and change the quantity to something big. So now we've changed this request, but nothing has happened to it because it's still in ZAP. If you have a look at there are some extra controls next to the button which we use to set the breakpoint, and that is submit and step to the next request or response, and submit and continue to the next breakpoint. Now, what this will do is submit and step will basically take you to the next point. So if I press that, then we will actually see we've now got the response coming back from ZAP. So here's all the data. So basically we're stepping through the requests one at a time. If we've made all the changes we want to, then we can use this submit and continue. And you'll see we've unset the global breakpoint. Now, if we switch back to the browser, we will see that actually the price didn't change. So that value in the post data is actually a red herring, but the quantity has changed. So we were able to change the quantity on the fly, which is what we wanted to do. Now, whether we want it to be this value here is another matter. But what it shows you is that we can change any value in any part of any request or response on the fly in ZAP. So this is really powerful, allows you to do lots of fun things. And that is the break functionality. Well, it's not quite everything. So there are more subtleties, which I will cover now. So one thing you will notice is that if we actually put on the global breakpoint, then every time we go anywhere, we actually have to keep on submitting, and it gets quite annoying. Now, in a traditional web app like Budget, it's not too bad, but if you've got a modern web app, then these will often be making lots of requests in the background, and you'll find yourself flooded. You won't be able to actually intercept and change the request that you really want. So for that reason, we have this other option, which is adding custom HTTP breakpoints. And that's a little X value with a plus on it. So what we can do now is we can choose either, we can match on anything in the URL, request header, body, response header or body. We can match a string or a regex, and we can break on that basis. Now, you can put all these values in here, but you might find it easier if it's a URL you're looking for to actually go to the history, or you can go to the sites tree as well. And here we've got the basket. So in this case, we just want to intercept requests to the basket. So we can right click, and there's the break option here. And then it's a URL, it's a regex, and there's the string. So we'll save that. And you'll see this breakpoint tab, breakpoints tab here appears, and you'll see it's an HTTP breakpoint, and there's the condition. So now the global breakpoint hasn't been set, but we have this breakpoint on a specific URL. So if I go back to Budget, then I can actually navigate around here, and if it's a modern web app, then it can make all these requests and responses, get responses in the background, and you won't have to worry about them. It's only when you go to a particular URL is requested, that's when you're going, okay, now I can actually change things. And here you can see that basically I have to kind of step through until I get to the point where I want to, okay, update the basket, and then we can update it to say have a negative number in, and there's the response coming back, and we will see that we now have a negative quantity and the store owes us money, which is always nice. So that is what these breakpoints are, conditional breakpoints, and you can enable them and disable them very quickly. So if you don't want to actually, so if you want to have a set of breakpoints available to you, you can then enable them whenever you want, and then ZAP will intercept the requests as required, and you can disable them. Something else I should have mentioned is we can drop requests. So you can bin requests or responses via the kind of no entry sign button there. And that basically just gets rid of whatever that request or response. So it means the browser will just not see that, either the browser or the server will not see them. And sometimes it's quite useful to be able to drop requests or responses, particularly in modern web applications. So that is most of the break functionality, but there are a few options. So if you go to the options, they're actually split across a couple of screens just to make things a little bit confusing. I think it's historical rather than anything else. So if we go to display, then there's an option for the break buttons only in the toolbar, only in the break panel, or in both the break panel and toolbar. So I will select that option, and you will now see that we've got the break options down here in the break toolbar as well as in the main toolbar. Is that more useful for you? You know, you can choose wherever you want these things to be. Some people prefer them one way, some people prefer them the other. We also have a breakpoints option tab. You can see we've got an option here to confirm whether we drop the trapped message. So I'll just set that, go and update. And if I say drop now, it'll say, do you want to drop the trapped message? And I'll choose to drop it in this case. So that allows you to choose whether do you want a confirmation or not. We also have an option to break only on messages in scope. Hopefully you know what scope means, but that's all to do with context. There are other videos on these things. But that can be very useful if you have a quite a narrowly defined scope, or if your application is making lots of requests to other URLs. Here's the option for ZAP always being on top when the breakpoint is hit, so you can turn that off. And you can show buttons to select requests you don't want ZAP to break on. And these buttons are kind of shown defined below. So if I enable that, you will actually see, now these don't appear in the main toolbar because that's getting quite crowded, but you will see, let me move ZAP down a little bit so hopefully we can see the hover overs. We will see we have an option to set ignore breaks on JavaScript files, ignore on CSS fonts, ignore on multimedia. So these are all options. You can just enable those buttons to make sure that you don't keep on get breaking on things you're really not interested in. And finally, we do have an option for, so the break button by default is combined button, but we can have separate ones for requests and responses. So if I choose that, then you'll see both in the break tab, we have these buttons for just breaking on all requests and breaking on all responses. And we've got the same thing in the main toolbar. So if you know you only want to break on requests or just break on responses, or be able to choose between them, then you can set these. They are, as you can see, they change dynamically. So it just gives you more control over the break functionality. So that is it for the break functionality. Now, one thing I want to point out is this is very much a manual technique. If you want to automate these things, so always change things in requests or responses, then we have a replacer option. And I will quickly, so that is down here. And that's something that I don't think I've covered in videos either. So that's something I probably ought to cover in another video. But we're trying to keep these ones very focused on particular features. So that's it from the break functionality. Hope you enjoyed it. Please leave comments below and let us know what else you'd like us to cover. Thank you very much.